वेरी गुड डे माय डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी लर्न ए चैप्टर नंबर 9, दैट इज मोर ऑन जीआईएमपी। लेट अस सी।
सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट आर टॉपिक विल कवर? फर्स्ट इंप्रूविंग डिजिटल फोटोज, इंट्रोडक्शन टू लेयर्स, सिलेक्शंस एंड पाथ्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, कैन यू सी हियर द पिक्चर्स व्हिच आर बीइंग अवेलेबल? व्हाट आर दिस? दिस आर द फोटोज दैट आर outcomes of editing to create illusion and unrealistic photos. What are the tools and features which might be used in such kind of editing? List them. So we will find out what are the tools we can use for editing this type of pictures. Okay, so see, improving digital photos. How could we improve the digital photos? By editing or improving a digital photos are scaling, cropping, adjusting the brightness and contrast, rotating, straightening, sharpening. Okay, these are some of the features which are being available in your mobile as well as in system when you able to open the any of the image. Okay, when you will try to edit it, no, it is available. The edit option is available in all the images. Okay, preloaded it is. Small things you can be able to edit, like how to crop it, how to scale it. Okay, adjusting the brightness or contrast. Okay, so what is brightness here? Brightness is the overall lightness or darkness of the image. You can bright your image or you can dark it. Okay, contrast is what differences in brightness between the objects in a photo, and resolution is what number of pixels in an image. It represents the quality of the pictures. Okay, now the first part we learn as what scaling a photo. What do you mean by scaling a photo? Okay, modern digital cameras capture photos with high resolution. Okay, and higher resolution photos take up larger space when they are required. You can see your image when you are clicking the image, it is what 4 MB or 5 MB image. So it takes a lot of space for that. Okay, it is a high resolution picture. So for that, there you will find some components like namely width, height and resolution to see the image size and values other than pixel. So you can adjust those resolution and you can set it. That is known as what? Scaling. Scaling the image means what? Setting the resolution of the image. Okay, it compresses your image, or while you compress your image, it will take the lesser space in your computer or in your mobile devices. Okay, next is your cropping. Cropping means what? Some of the parts which you don't want, okay, that part to be cropped out. Okay, so for that we use what? Crop tool. It can be selected from the toolbox and it looks like what? Scalpel blade. Scalpel blade means what? Like this it will be looked out. Okay, this type of tool it will be looked out. To crop a photo, press the left mouse button in the photo window and you can be able to crop it. Okay, in the mobile also the crop option is available. By using that you could be able to crop your image. Next is your brightening and darkening. Brightening and darkening is what? Brighten the image or darken your image. If you think that it is a quite brightened, so you can dark it. Okay, you can utilize it, you can white balance. There are many type of contrast tools are available to set your image darkness or brightness. Okay, so brightness contrast tool, this tool is often useful for photos that are overexposed or underexposed, but it's not useful for correcting color cast. The tool gives you two sliders to adjust for brightness and contrast. Okay, when you will choose the brightness tool, brightness and contrast is available. You can choose which by adjusting your brightness, you can adjust it. See, brightness and contrast is available. You can adjust those things and you can press on OK. Next is your levels. Levels is what? Level tools. It is a sophisticated way of correcting exposure problem by using level tools. The dialog for this tool looks very complicated, but for the basic usage, the only part the user needs to deal with the input level areas. Okay, it is this triangular sliders is available. Next is your curves. What is curve? A very powerful way of correcting exposure problem to use the curve tool. If you want to curve it, okay, if the image is like straight, so if you want to curve it, so it could be curved out. Okay, this tool allows you to click and drag control points on a curve, mapping input brightness level to output brightness levels. the hue and saturation. If photo has a color cast that is too much of red, blue, green or other colors, the easiest way to color it use the hue and saturation. It will adjust the level of the color which is being used in the pictures. Okay. Next, rotate and straighten. If you are thinking that your photo has been rotated, so you can rotate it. Okay, so one image rotation is available. Rotate tool can be used to fix this kind of photos. Choose the tool from toolbox. If the advanced feature is available, you can default to the corrective background. Activate the tool by clicking on the photo with the tool, and tool options are available as a dialog box. Okay, you just need to click on the photograph, okay, and just rotate it. It will be rotated. Okay. Next is your sharpening. What is sharpening? If the photo gets blurred, okay, or hazy, on what is blurred, which is hazy or it is, which is not at all clear, okay, due to either the focus on the camera is not set. So for that, we will do what? We will sharp it. The most general useful technique for sharpening is a blurred photo is called what? Unsharp mask. Okay, to sharp the photo, we use which tool? Unsharp mask. Okay, so there are basically two parameters under which photos can be sharpened. They are radius and amount. According to radius and amount, whenever you click on the sharpens, so these two options will be available. You can adjust its radius and sharpen according to the photograph need, and you can then press OK. When you click on OK, you will find whatever the sharpens or adjustment you have done. According to that, you can see. Okay, see the photo which was not clear, and after that which is being cleared, please shown. Okay, fixing red eye. See, this photo is red eye, so how to fix it? So red eye effect, how to move? When a photo is captured with a flashlight and a person is in front of camera is looking directly toward the camera, the iris of the eye has the ability to bounce back, and it appeared as what? Bright eye. And this effect is called what? Red eye effect. Sometimes it happens, right, students? So what to do? Using GIMP, zoom the area around the eye so that it is nice and large and easy to work with. Draw a rectangle around the eye, and now select enhance and red eye removal. You need to draw a rectangle, and then where to click? In the filters, you need to click enhance and then red eye removal. Then you will find the red eye removal is being removed. Next, introduction to layers. In GIMP, each individual transparency is called a what? Layer. The layer are stacked on one another, and all layers put together gives the final product. Each layer is allowed to work without disturbing the other layer image editing. Whenever we work, it works in layers. Okay, now each open photo has at any time a single active drawable. A drawable is something that includes layer, channel, layer mask and selection mask. What is drawable and layer mask? Drawable means what? Anything that can be drawn with painting tools. And layer mask is what? Basic tools in image control. They allow us to modify the transparency of the layer. Now next is selection. Whenever you do any type of function, you need to do what? You need to do first selection, then only you can do any type of changes in that. Okay, that is what selection. So only part of photo can be editing by selecting the required part of the photo, then only you can do the editing part. Without selection, you could not edit or cannot apply anything in your photograph. Okay, so this is what your selection. Now paths. What is paths? Paths is a one-dimensional curve. Path tool from the tool options. From where you can get the path tool? You will get the path tool from the tool options, which are used to create and manipulate a photo. Path like layers and channels are components of a photo. The list of paths in a photo are displayed and can be operated from the paths dialog. Paths are of two types, open path and closed path. This is open path and this one is a closed path. Okay. A closed path can be converted in a selection. Closed path means that the last anchor point is connected to the first anchor. Last path is connected to the first anchor. When a path is transformed into a selection, any open component is automatically converted into a closed component. An open or closed path can be painted on a photo in a variety of ways. Okay. Now GIMP paths are Bezier path. What is Bezier path? It is a curve or line used to create vector graphics. Okay, curve okay, that is known as what? Beezer path. Now, anchor are the points that the path goes through. Handle defines the direction of the path at as it enters or leaves an anchor point. Now, path contains multiple components. That is a part of a path which anchor points are all connected to each other by path segments. A path all whose segments are straight is called what? Polygonal. So, this is what your path. Using this, you could be able to draw any type of components. Okay, this is a curved path, this one is a polygonal path. So these are the path which GIMP has the option transform a selection in a photo into a path and paths into a selection. Okay, so this is all about GIMP. Thank you, students.